See, what we did on yesterday, we were talking about the view state. Okay, so what is the definition for the view state? And you have to prepare for the interview as well. Okay, for the view state. If you view state is nothing but if you want to maintain a data, okay, on the same page, where you are doing a multiple postbacks, multiple requests you are sending for the same page. In that case, if you want to maintain the data, in that case, you can go with the view state. Okay, let me open the Google. Okay, I think so you guys already have it. What is view state? I'm writing only. What is view state? And also look into that. Okay, I'm just typing for you. View state is the method that ASP.NET page frameworks uses to preserve page and control bit values between the round trips. Means you have a page, you are clicking on button, you are clicking on radio button, drop down list, whatever. You are doing the postbacks. When the HTML markup for the page is rendered, once you got the page from the server, the current state of the page and the value that must be retained during the postback. Means I have sent a request to the server, it returned me an HTML or some data. If I am going to make a second request, so in that case, whatever the data came on the first request, I wanted to maintain on the next request as well. In that case, you can go with the view state. And view state will be data is base 64 encoded strings. Is what? Base 64 encoded string means executing it. Right click view page source. This is the view state data. It is in encoded format. If you put some huge amount of data, it will be maintained in this format only, Unicode 64. Okay. So we'll do a lot of things here. Let's start with first login page, which I have created yesterday. To start a data access layer or business layers and all those things, but didn't. Going to the login, the next topic which we are going to cover, that's a session. What is session? Suresh, we'll start from you. What is session?
Session, so which will contain the session ID for a particular username and password, which has been which will store in cookies.
It is nothing but a period between its login and logout.
You can say session means actually Suresh is also in okay. Session in simple thing, I can say if you maintain the user information throughout the application from login till logout, in that case, we can go for the session. Session will be maintained by using some session IDs. I can store any type of data in the session object. Okay, that will be maintained throughout the entire application instance until or unless your logout process gets happened. That we call as a session. So how can we do that? For example, I am going to write some code. I'm not going to check username and the password. Okay, I'll do that. But when we will work on data access layer and business layer. Meanwhile, you can also do some login check from your end. Login check we already did in Windows application. How we did? If TXT username, I'm just checking with the hard coded from the database. Okay, not from the database, hard coded value equals to password is text. Thank you. Now, for example, if user is successful, then I need to navigate to the home page of the user. Response, this is a class, HTTP response dot. There is a method called redirect where you want to navigate it after login. Okay, specify your page name where you want to navigate it. Now, I'm adding one more page here. Page name is, we can consider as home page or dashboard. I can mention as dashboard. Dashboard.aspx. It's nothing but I'm just writing the dashboard page. Once you logged in, I need to navigate to the dashboard page. .aspx. That's it.
So वो नाम अलग है पेज का.
Okay. Spelling mistake हो गया मुझसे. Login. Set a start page. See here. The password is 123. You can set this password as a text mode. Password text mode equal to password. Click on login. It is going here. Check the text equals to what is the text admin and the password is 123. Okay. It is successful. I'm just navigating to the different page. Press F11. Now where it is going, see dashboard.aspx page. Okay. Name it here. If you want, this is my page. Rerun it. Click on login. It is coming here. Then it will navigate to the different page. This is my home page. I did it. But somebody copied this URL. I copied it. Okay. Stop the session. Opening to the browser. Paste it. Press enter. See, I'm able to get it. Even though this page should not be available until or unless you will not log into the application. That must have to be specified. You have to be specify your credentials, then you should move to the next page. This is the first requirement. What I need to do, I am creating some session variable here. Session square bracket, I'm putting a value, for example, user name bracket equals to txt username.txt. This variable is available throughout your application flow. So this is the dashboard page. View state will be available on the same page. You cannot transfer the data from one page to another page using a view state. View state will be applicable on the same page on multiple postbacks, multiple round trips, request, but in the session variable will be available throughout your application. I created session under session square bracket, something like a view state we did. Username. On the dashboard page, I'm just going to the view code on the page load side. I'm able to print response dot write dot to string. This is an object, that's why we have to convert it. Okay. Let's run it. Okay. Now I will enter admin 123. Click on login. Admin is coming from the previous page. Value is available. If I wanted to get the use state value, it won't be available.
Because it is only available on the same page.
Use state will be available on the same page. Now the URL is getting changed. That means you have loaded a new page. That means view state will not be available on the next. It will be on the previous page. But if you want to maintain some specific data related to a user, you can go with the session. Now, I did this. Can I do on the dashboard page? Because previously I hit it this URL here, Control A, Control C, and I'm able to paste it and I was getting the data. I was able to access it. Now, what I'm doing, instead of printing something, before going to printing, can I check if session square bracket username, the name square bracket is not equal to null, then it should print or it will process the things. Else you are not authorized. I can navigate to a different page. Can I create a different page? For example, adding one page, add new item. I'm just mentioning the page name as error.page. Okay. Page. So I'm writing here, you are not authorized. Okay. Please re-log in. Something I did it. Go and check first. So I'm writing here response dot redirect. I'm navigating it. If the user is not authenticated, dot means the session is not available. I'm just putting in single double quotes error dot ASPX. Now let's see that one. Admin, putting 123, click on login. It is coming here. I captured the text box value here itself. It is navigating to a different page. Point here, sorry. Click on login. It is coming here. Then it should navigate to a different page, dashboard.aspx. Now I am checking whether the value is available or not. Okay, because the session variable value is available throughout your application. Go to the quick watch, you will see the value available. So based on that, I can check, okay, this is the value available, then I can print it or I can process the thing. So I'm able to access it. Now, what I'm doing, just copy this URL, stop it, go to the page, paste, press enter. You are not authorized. It went to error.aspx. Got it? Any doubt? Yes. So see, it navigated to a different page, error.aspx. Session value, session data is not available on the dashboard. So every page you have to check whether the session value is available or not. If it is not available, then throw out to some error page. Okay. Now.
Charger.
But if you remember, guys, yesterday I did. I was writing like this code, right? In the view state. Every time you check the variable value, correct? Something like this. Can I create this thing, same thing for the session? Just go, add one class here first, right click, add new item. I'm just giving a name as, for example, session management. I'm giving management. Means whatever the session variables I'm going to create it, I'll create it here. Okay. I paste it here. Okay. Now, it will return a string variable, string data, str. A string, not records. I'm just putting session user. This is a variable name. Okay. I write a string result, or I can put it as string.lp. Initializing it. You have to make a practice like this only. Here I can write session. SSSION. If I'm not able to write a session here. See, I'm not able to write a session. Here I was able to write session keyword. Session is coming where? System.web.sessionState.httpsessionState. This is the way of. If I'm not able to access the variable, how you will get it? Just make an habit. You always have to write HTTP context dot current dot. You will find the view state and everything. Now, this is a class which will provide you everything for related to session, view state, whatever you want. Just type casting with the string. Make a same variable name for use, make it as a user friendly. This one. And, what we can do? It's a standard way of doing. Okay, now is the session user. Can I write something like this here itself? In the login page, I'm writing like this. Okay, many people are doing like this only. There's no problem over there. Session, what is the variable name which I have created? Session user, right? Session management, you will see session user. Okay. Now I'm writing session user. Right click on it, you will. Okay, because I have to create a static things. I can use something in a different way. For example, and namespace public class login. I clicked on no button that period. That is why it should not be required, because when I was adding it, I pressed on no. It should be yes. Every class or C hash classes will go into the app code folder. Okay, now it's going with the here session management. Let's see whether I am able to use the session variable. Might be I won't be able to use it. That's true. So what I can do? Session management, yes, just simple words. S dot, I'm using this session user. Okay, I'll just write user session object. It, paste it, equals to txt username. That's true. That will work. Now, if I wanted to exit it somewhere, I can go here in this default.aspx page. I can check it. I'll get the value here itself. Okay. I'm going to use this one. We'll see the value is available or not. I can use it directly even though. You can just check it here also. User variable is not empty, then it should go here and print it. Let's do that. There are some other ways I'll share with you. Okay, no worry. Login page. coming here. I created an object. The value is getting captured in this variable. Okay. Press F10. It is going here. See the value is available or not. The variable value is available. Based on that, you can put some conditions. Instead of writing every time what we were writing, session, square bracket, then key name, it should not be a right way of doing it. Okay? Because suppose that there is a big application and multiple people are working on that. Okay? Somebody has created a variable which is holding a data from the database. For example, it is holding the data of user details. I got the data from the database and I have captured into the particular session objects. If you are using like this, square bracket, something like this, I'm using it. So I need to remember it wherever I wanted to use to get the user details. I have to remember this keyword. I have to write like this. But if somebody has exposes a property to you, which is responsible for giving you some data, which you already captured some data from the database and captured into a session, that would be really nice. I can use directly instead of writing a separate code for session and all those things. So always try to make an habit use like this. Create a class, put some objects or variables or get set property, and assign a values like this. If I'm going for a view state, I can put it here itself. But the view state page variable value will be available only for the single page. It won't go for some other pages. Now see, in the dashboard, what I'm doing, I'm just printing the username, whoever the person joined, okay? I've not created any design till now. Don't focus on that, the designing where it looks in the application. I'm just giving a name, LBL username. Okay. I wanted to print a username value in the label. So what I can do, go to the different dashboard. Instead of printing something, if you want to print, you can go with that. Else, LBL username dot text equals to, I can write username user session dot session user. I can put it like this. Silver, this is the use of programming. Instead of writing a session square bracket or view state square bracket or cache or cookies. Because if I shared you that thing only, that would also work. But if you got some legacy projects, in that case, they have created these types of classes. So there is a lot of problems with you while debugging the code. You have to understand it because you will be able to get the property, but you will not be able to understand where they have set, where the code was written. You have to debug each and everything. So if you know these things, okay, I can create an object. I can put the values here in this get set, because in the, even the get set properties, if you navigate from one page to another page, the data will not be available. So if you want to maintain it, go with the session. I can do like this. Now, this is the session. In the dashboard page, I was able to print the label or the username. I'm putting one button which is responsible for logging out the session. BTN session logout. I can make it as logout. Just remember one thing, we'll have a session on weekends. Okay. Double click on the logout. If the user already created a session, now I wanted to log out the session. So what I am doing, I created this class here itself. Create it here also. I can write a code session dot. There are three methods called remove. Remove means which key you want to remove it. The key which I have created, where you can understand the keys. If you go to the class, the key which I have given, that's a session user. I can put it like this also. Session.remove. means you can remove the session here itself. Once you log out, then you need to navigate to the previous page. If you want to really check whether the value is available or not after logging out, I can check it here. If session user equals to null, there is one more way of doing that. I can make it as session equals to null. I can do this way also. It is nothing but a setting of values, setting the null values to this variable. You can do like this also. But if you want to specifically working with the sessions, you have to use some keywords remove. Okay. If the session user becomes null, because this is the session user variable, I created a property. Inside that, you can see they already have the key name, session user. I can use like this also, or I can use like this also. If the session user is null, means after logging out, you have to redirect to response.redirect. I can put it as, what was the page? Login.aspx. I can make it as. Let's run it. Now, see, I'm going to run which page? We need to concept. I'll explain you like the other things as well. We'll do one sample, okay? But now just understand the concept, how it is working. See, it is coming here. Now clicking onto the logout button, it is coming here. They see the session is being removed. Let's see, the value is available or not? Not. If I have not written anything, once again, running it once again, execute it. Click on login, log out. See the value is available or not? See the value is available. Because it is nothing but this property having some key. The key name which we have provided, that's a session user. So what I did, either I can just use the session user equals to null, I can set it manually, or else you can use session.remove. Session user, it will remove there. So right now it will not go inside that loop, so it will come out. You will see the same page, but it's not the good once you remove the session.